بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. So the Sheikh today has started reciting Surah Al-An'am, the cattle. It's called the cattle because in all the surahs, this is the surah whereby the cattle is mentioned the most. Al-An'am is mentioned the most. Cattle meaning, you know, cows and camels and goats and sheep. So it's called Surah Al-An'am. It is Surah number 6 in the Quran. It has 160 ayat in two juz, juz number 7 and 8. This surah, although it's considered to be from As-Sab'at Tawal, the seven long ones, unlike An-Nisa, Al-Ma'ida, Al-Imran, Al-Baqarah, that were revealed in Medina, this surah is a Makki surah. The surah was revealed in Mecca, except there's a difference or discrepancy between al-ilm with regard to only one ayah. Some said that this particular ayah, جَعَلْنَهُمْ قَرَاطِيس, it is a Madani ayah, but the surah in its entirety is a Makki surah. In terms of its revelation, it's number 54. Number 54 in the Nuzul. And it has seven or eight reasons as to why the surah was revealed, mostly pertinent to the people of the book, is pertinent to al-Yahud, is pertinent to Musaylim al-Kadhab, it's also pertinent to the empowerment of the believers. So the theme of the surah, is about Tawheed, is about showing the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Starting from, let's say, ayah verses number 59. Ayah number 59 from surah, what surah are we talking about so far? Surah Al-An'am. So I'm just making sure that you're following. By the way, when our dear brother Asad mentioned that every tafsir I give you one ayah, and I say this ayah will change your life, inshallah ta'ala. So at the end of, I said, the 9th of the 27th, I will give, there will be a prize. There will be a prize, there will be a quiz. Two quizzes, one for the sisters and one for the brothers. We will have a special quiz, not Nabi, and inshallah, a very good prize. So try to remember these particular ayat you know, that I'm mentioning or that I'm sharing with you. Verse number 59. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is maybe for me one of the most powerful ayat in the Quran. وعنده مفاتيح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب مبين. This ayah, brothers and sisters, is about you can run but you cannot hide. وعنده مفاتيح الغيب. Learn it, teach it to your children, teach it to your spouses, teach it to your friends. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the key to all unseen subhanahu wa ta'ala. وعنده مفاتيح الغيب. The key to unseen. Nobody knows them except Allah. وعنده مفاتيح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر. He knows that which is in the air, he knows that which is in the sea. Nothing escapes him سبحانه وتعالى. The name of Allah السميع, the name of Allah البصير, the name of Allah الرقيب. One of the most beautiful names of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, الرقيب, the watchful. Yes, you can fool me, but you cannot fool Allah. Teach that to your children. When you come home and you tell Beta, Betty, did you do your sabah? Did you do your namaz? He says, yes, Baba. They may lie to you. You can lie to me, but you cannot lie to Allah. Allah knows whether you did your sabah or not. Allah knows whether you did this or not. Right? Teach that to your children. Teach that. Tell them that I might not be here. I could be trying, but you could tell me so I can hug you, I can give you some money, but you cannot hide from Allah because Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّا هُمْ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحَرِ. Everything that happens in this universe, Allah knows of it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every tree, every leaf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also about the leaf in a tree. This leaf in the tree, my brothers and sisters, Allah knows that particular leaf that fell, let's say, somewhere in some country, somewhere. And how many turns or flips it flipped in the air before it dropped on the ground and where in the ground it dropped. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it all. So remember this, my brothers and sisters. This surah is about tawheed, is about the empowerment knowing that Allah Azza wa Jal is the controller of this universe. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala also says, لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار. Nobody can see him, but he sees you all. You can't hide to commit a sin late at night when your parents are asleep or your spouse is asleep, and then you're watching something that you think nobody is watching. Allah knows what you're doing. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-Sami' al-Basir al-Alim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in Surah Al-An'am as well, من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها. This particular ayah is so beautiful because it empowers you to do more khair, to do more good. If you were to do one hasana, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you 10 hasanat. For every hasana that you do, Allah will give you 10. But for every sayi'ah, it will only be one sayi'ah, equivalent to one sayi'ah. But for one hasana, it's equivalent to 10. But in Ramadan, is multiplied in manifold. Meaning, if you were to donate $1, let's say, fi sadaqah, today in Ramadan, is it going to be $10? No, it's going to be multiplied in manifold, much, much more than whatever that you have given. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do good, more good in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in this particular surah, Surah Al-An'am, and I think I would end with this because it's already 6 minutes and 30 seconds. I will tell you or share with you the surah that will change your life. Remember, a surah that will change you, or an ayah, I'm sorry, an ayah that will change your life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-An'am, verse number 17.
وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ.
Brothers and sisters, delegate your affairs to Allah. Sometimes we may be afflicted by some harm, disease, a loss of a job, a loss of a good one or a loved one. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, if you were to be afflicted by some harm, nobody can alleviate that harm except Allah. Allah is al-Shafi. Allah is al-Shafi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who provides the cure. Sometimes you may do certain things which is haram just so that we can meet the needs somehow. But let yourselves know that the only one who can alleviate your harm, your stress and your distress and whatnot is Allah. In this pandemic, a lot of us may have lost jobs, a lot of us may have lost loved ones, a lot of us may have gone through so many hardships, but the only one who can alleviate those hardships is, I want to hear you, is Allah. And that's what Allah is saying in this ayah, verse number 17. إِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ إِلَّا هُوَ. And Allah says in Surah Al-Naml, He says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Allah says, who is the one who answers the call of the needy? Who is the one who alleviates your pain, your stress, your distress? Who is the one who makes your inheritance in land? أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Is there anyone other than Allah? Nobody other than Allah who can do so, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one who can give me shifa. He's the one who can protect me. He's the one who can protect my children. He's the one who can protect my parents. He's the one who can bring, alhamdulillah, give me this health and this life and whatnot. It is only Allah, and I'm only here because of Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think that you're here because you're smart. Don't think you're here because you're beautiful or handsome. That people who are more handsome than you, they didn't make it here. Don't think that you're here because you're fortunate or wealthy. That people who are healthier than you, they couldn't make it here today. We're here because of Allah. Say alhamdulillah. Jazakum Allah khair. May Allah bless you. May Allah reward you. Jazakum Allah khair. Again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.